hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Thank you for always coming here. The name of my channel is Education and Entertainment Center. We all know that education, we educate ourselves on some of the trending topics, and we also do entertainment because I tell stories on this channel, short stories. So today I'm going to be talking about this topic that has been going on social media. This topic is about Cameroon and some African countries banning Nigerian music. I say I should throw some light on this channel, and especially to Cameroonians. As you can see, today I'm dressed in a Cameroonian traditional outfit. I'm just sitting here. You can see part of it. This is Cameroonian outfit, so beautifully made. And then we have the gele, this Nigeria hitai. You see Cameroonian Nigeria. It's a mixture. You see, this is part of life. When you mix things from different places, it's a spice of life. I mean, it looks beautiful, as if it was the same thing. So this is Cameroonian, this is Nigeria, part of Nigeria dressing. So let's jump back into our topic. I was talking about the fact that Cameroonians and some other African countries are banning Nigeria music. I've always said it in my channel that before I became a YouTuber, I was watching a lot of YouTube videos. Then after learning from me, what did I do? I said I was going to start a channel. So it is the same thing. If we have been consuming a lot of Nigerian music, have we just been consumers, or have we learned how to produce our own? When you consume something, oh, please learn how to do it. Learn how to do it. If that's what people want, if that's what is selling, you have to learn how to do it. So if we have been making that mistake of just being consumer, please, we also have to be producers and suppliers too to other parts. The world now is a global village. You can produce something and sell it all around the world. Nigeria have learned that. Let's learn it too. It's never too late. Let's wake up. I know some, we are doing our best. We cannot just be giving fish. We should also learn how to fish, you know, so that the whole life will not be begging for fish. So those are some of the things we should learn. Let's not just be consumers. I said again, we should be producers. Let's get closer to people who are already doing something and learn how they do it, so that it will benefit other of us. And then we should learn to support each other. Cameroonian, please wake up. You do not support your own brothers and sisters who are trying to do something out there, even people who sing music. I know people complain, oh, we need sponsor. No, this is a modern era. You don't need sponsor. You can just be hidden anything behind your door, and then depend on what you are selling. Beatings and anything, it works. Look at the music Jerusalem. What was so sophisticated about that music? Somebody just came out there and only the beatings of it, and the whole world is liking it and using it. So you don't need to teach it. So what I was telling my brothers and sisters in Cameroon is that please support each other. Support them. If you can support them with money, fine. If you can sponsor their music, fine. Their videos, fine. But if you cannot, please. And this is social media. Social media means it's all about subscribers, followers, like, share. So if you cannot support them with money, you can follow them on social media, you can like, and it doesn't cost you anything to just hit the subscribe button, to hit the follow button, to like, to share. It doesn't cost you any money. It just costs a little bit of your time, because you know that when you do that, when you do things like that, because any social media platform has rules. Like in YouTube, they say that when you have 1,000 subscriber and 4,000 watch hours of your video, you start getting paid. So it's not for free. When people do videos like that, be on YouTube, on Facebook pages, on TikTok, on Instagram, it's not for free. That's why Nigeria have learned that. They have learned. They have grabbed the concept of selling their talent around the world. Let's not be left behind. Let's wake up. Let's do something. That's why I did a video saying that supporting each other on any social media platform. Let's support. And Cameroonians, please, when you produce something, don't wait too long to produce another thing. Like if you let me show you a video of just common additional problem, and it's a whole comedy in Nigeria. You see how talented they are. Let's watch.
I collected 2,500 naira from you.
Yeah.
And another 2,500.
Yeah.
Making it 5,000.
41,000.
Huh?
41,000.
2,500
plus
2,000. That is
5,000. Oh my God.
5,000 naira.
That is
41,000.
Yes.
I say you collect 2,500.
Uh-huh.
Plus 2,500.
Uh-huh.
0 plus 0.
0.
0 plus 0.
0.
5 plus 5.
10.
2 plus 2.
4.
41,000. 0 plus 0.
0.
0 plus 0.
0.
5 plus 5.
10.
I write 10. Mm. 2 plus 2. 4 now. Mm.
You carry 1. You carry 1. You carry 1.
Where you dey carry and go? Carry 1 go where?
Hey!
See, it's just a comedy. There was nothing. There's no sponsor. There's no. You didn't. The people did not overdress, and the scene and the background is not even anything. But what they are saying is so funny, and people around Nigeria is producing something that is good at. We also love it in Cameroon. Let's learn how to do it ourselves. If we like it, learn it. Speaking African countries banning Nigeria music. I also share this topic with a sister. We are going to listen to her video and see what she has to say. Please let's listen and watch.
Hello, hello, hello everyone. This is your fun day. My name is Belinda Archer. We got some very fun music going on right here. Music from Cameroon. Enjoy the music with me before we get into the topic for today. The reason why we're here. It's very interesting. Let's listen to the music. One. I said that I'm a tango dapper. I don't want to write this music, guys. We just use it for entertainment. It's very fun. Here's your fun guy here. We learn, we talk the fun way on this channel, guys. So let's enjoy this music. It's music from Cameroon. Oh, this is music from Cameroon, guys. So interesting. I think the artist is, I see Magasco, I see Miss Alice. I've turned down the music a little bit, and today we are here to answer a question as to whether it is proper for some Cameroonian artists to ban foreign music, especially Nigerian music in Cameroon, in attempt to promote their own industry, their own music. That is a question we have in front of us, posed to me by someone, and I'm trying to digest it and give us an answer that I think will be proper for us, and to advise ourselves and our fellow artists on what we can do moving forward, guys, right? All we want to do is we enjoy first. We enjoy Cameroon music. We love our music. I personally, I love it. I can play this song. I relate with the costume. I relate with the food. I relate with everything about it. So we want to hear more of this. Your own city, your town, your environment. I love that, guys. So sometimes we play a lot of foreign music, and I'll be like, oh, I wish we had all this music in our own area, you know? So, guys, going back to the question as to whether it is proper for Cameroonian artists or some Cameroonian artists to ban foreign music in an attempt to promote their own Cameroon music industry. One, before I answer the question, I would like to say this. Entertainment. Music is meant for entertainment. It is okay. You can entertain yourself with a music that is sung in a language that you do not understand at all. But you cannot entertain yourself with music that doesn't sound proper to you, that doesn't sound enjoyable to you, that doesn't sound fun to you. So what I can say to our fellow artists is, please do your best to put out good music out there. When you put out good music, there's no way nobody can even stop it. The time you use to fight those who are already out there trying to stop their music, guys, all I can say is try to put that time in working hard as to produce good music. When you produce good music, you don't have time to go chasing somebody not to come to the market. You'll be out there, be busy trying to instead of fighting to stop what somebody else have out there, try to find out what are they doing that is better, what is making their music good, and try to look at it from that direction, and try to work on your own work and your own work of art, work on your music, try to make it look good, and it will excel, it will sell, guys. That is a little advice I can say to our fellow Cameroonian artists. We love you guys. We love our music. We love our country. We want to see more of our Cameroon music. We want to be proud, like, you know, the few that we have out here. We have Daphne. I enjoy her music. We have my guys going back, Mr. Leo, Mr. Lee, and a few, or there are some other ones that I have been listening to. And they are really good, but it's just that when they sing one, it takes a long time for them to produce other music. So we want to see these things coming up. And besides, a lot of people listen to Nigerian music, because when you go to, especially like YouTube, to search for music, they're just popping up. You don't even need to search for them. They just pop up. Nobody will go looking for something that's right there in front of you. If you want to entertain yourself with music, mostly our African beats is almost the same. So, oh, here's another Magasco. Very interesting. I love it. So, guys, let's try our Cameroonian artists. What I can tell you guys is to try, work hard, and try to put your music out there. Try to sing good music. When you have a good music, it will be out there. Trust me, guys. You don't have to chase anybody out of the market to sell. When your music is good, it will sell itself. So spend that time in working hard to produce something good than chasing somebody else. You will just be like wasting your energy in the wrong direction. Put your energy in the right direction and you will stand out there. There's no magic about it. Entertainment is entertainment. Even if you chase all the international artists or Nigerian artists out of the market, if you don't produce good music, trust me, it will still not change anything. So we are saying that we have a couple of good music out there. We need more. Please, I know that the Cameroonian music industry is still very young. They have some difficulties, financial difficulties, sponsorship difficulties, and all that. But guys, all I can tell you is keep doing your best. Work hard, pray somebody, you get a sponsor, or do the best you can do. Just work. Your target should be, I want to put out good music. If you have this mindset, guys, trust me, you will stand out. For example, see the guy in South Africa, the guy who sang Jerusalem or something. He did not know how far this song was gonna go. It blew the world, it blew the mind of everybody. It's all over the world. That's what I'm talking about, guys. Work on your music. Don't spend your energy trying to fight somebody. Spend your energy trying to do something that is good, and you'll stand out there. For the meantime, my name is Belinda Archer. I'm one of your fun girls. I have a lot of YouTube videos. We talk, we learn on this channel the fun way. So guys, that is just it. We have to just entertain ourselves, enjoy life the best way we can. Okay.
Now that you have listened to another part of this, and hit the notification button so that you don't miss any other video. Thank you.